I'm Kimberly Arusha, Managing Director of the USGA Green Section. I'd like to welcome you to How It's Done. These presentations summarize methods and procedures observed by Green Section agronomists as they visit golf courses throughout North America. We are not suggesting that the procedures depicted are the best or only means of performing a particular task. Our goal is to share a broad variety of methods so that golf courses may benefit from the ideas and techniques.
How It's Done, Sampling Greens for Winterkill Injury. I'm Bob Vavrek, USGA Senior Agronomist for the North Central Region. Harsh winter weather can damage turf in several ways. For example, thick, dense ice cover can slowly suffocate the turf on a green over a period of several months. Or a green saturated with water from rain or melting snow can be killed instantly by a rapid drop in temperature to well below freezing. Regardless of how it occurs, severe winter injury to the putting surfaces can cripple a golf facility come spring when play and potential revenue goes elsewhere to nearby undamaged courses until the turf at your facility recovers. There's no need for you to guess what spring will bring when you can easily remove small plugs of turf from frozen greens throughout the winter and grow them indoors. So long as turf plugs green up when exposed to warm indoor temperatures and light, then there are no concerns for the health of the greens. If plugs do not green up when placed indoors, then this is your early warning that winterkill damage may have already occurred. While unfortunate, at least the facts are known in advance, and this provides extra time to develop an effective plan for recovery and the opportunity to communicate to golfers how these efforts will affect spring play. This is how it's done. This presentation and most of the photos comes to you from Blue Mound Golf and Country Club in Wauwatosa, Wisconsin, where Steve Houlihan is the golf course superintendent. Step 1, identify sample areas. The best places to sample are the areas of greens that have a past history of winterkill injury. They will typically be poorly drained areas of turf, especially areas affected by winter shade. Step 2, expose the turf. Remove snow to expose the putting surface. Be careful not to damage the dormant turf where there is no protective layer of ice. Chip away ice cover down to within 1/4 inch or so of the turf. Be safe and wear eye protection. A chisel and hammer are useful, but other tools, such as an ice spud or a small shovel, can be equally effective. Don't be surprised on a clear day if the last 1/4 inch of ice melts or separates from the turf when sunlight passes through the ice and warms up the surface of the green. Step 3, collect samples of turf. Use a cordless drill equipped with a 2-inch diameter hole cutter to cut through the frozen, exposed turf. Stop drilling a bit less than the full depth of the cutter to avoid physical damage to the turf. Insert a flathead screwdriver or chisel into the perimeter of the hole and apply a little sideways pressure to separate the base of the turf plug from the frozen soil. Remove the plug from the green and repeat the process until a representative sample of the turf is obtained. Step 4, move turf plugs indoors and monitor them for green up. Insert the plugs in a styrofoam coffee cup or a small peat flower pot filled with sand or potting soil. Place the turf samples on a sunny windowsill, south facing is best, or under a grow light, and apply a little water several times a day to prevent moisture stress. Green up can be accelerated by placing samples just beneath a high intensity fluorescent grow light and providing continuous light until live plants break dormancy, which usually takes about 2 to 3 days for turf. A compact, inexpensive jumpstart grow light system is ideal for small turf samples and they can be found at garden centers or online. Rarely is an entire putting surface lost to winterkill injury, so there is always a chance that you only sampled live turf and missed areas with dead turf. But taking several samples from areas of the green that are highly susceptible to winterkill damage will still provide valuable information. Take the time to sample greens that are subjected to long periods of ice cover or severe thaw-freeze events, and take the surprise out of winter injury.
This has been a USGA Green Section How It's Done presentation. For more golf course management information, visit www.usga.org and select the Course Care tab.